And now we're joined in the News Across Studios by Abdul Kabir Oyemoni, who is an Islamic educationist. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Let's start by looking at what is the essence of the Idil Kabir?
What should be noted first and foremost in the celebration of this Eid is the fear of Allah, the fear of God in anything we do. Because we should know that our forefather, our father Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam, he was made to sacrifice his son, which was later replaced by ram. So if he had not had utmost fear of Allah, he wouldn't be able to do that. He would not be able to follow. That's why Allah says that we don't want the flesh does not reach Allah. The flesh of that ram that you sacrificed on that day does not reach Allah. La yanalu la luhmuha wa la dimahuha wa la kinu yanaluhu taqwa minkum. That is, the fear of Allah is what Allah wants in the whole thing. So the summary of that thing is, we should fear Allah. You should fear Allah at the point of you sacrificing that particular ram at that point in time. It is never conceivable that somebody that is with sense as a Muslim will now think that you sacrifice any human being for anything in the name of Allah. It is not welcome in Islam. Okay. It is found out.
Now you've said that the sacrifice of the ram, which is significant to, or really compared to the sacrifice of the son of Prophet Ibrahim at that time. So, but in the face of the economic situation, is there an alternative to the ram? Must it be the ram, or are there other sacrifices that can be made?
You should know that anything in Islam, anything that wants to do in the religion of Islam, is there's no compulsion in anything. You must be fit to do a particular thing at a point in time. Mm. So if you are able to sacrifice cow, ram, and of course sheep, it is allowed. But if you don't have the means to do so, it is not compulsory on you any longer for that purpose.
In the face of this, now, several people have talked about living in harmony with each other, living peacefully and sharing. But in the face of the situation in the country where different people are clamoring for different things and the hate speech situation that the government is even cautioning about, what kind of lessons should Nigerians as a whole take out of this going beyond this celebration?
Like I said earlier on, it based on the fear of Allah. All of us in all across religious faithfuls, we believe, we say it out that we fear God, we fear Allah, by whatever nomenclature we want to call it. But in reality, we don't. If we do, we should have tolerance for one another. You know, we should be patient, because it was utmost patience on the part of the son, Ismail, alayhi salatu wasalam, that he agreed to his father that I am ready. And Allah tested them. He passed them, the two of them. Mm-hmm. So we have to pick the utmost fear of God. Maybe I should say God this time around, so that people will know that it is the fear of God that is demanded from all of us at that point in time. It is utmost patience on the part. It is like we say now in Nigeria, for instance, we are expected to fear God in anything we say. If you have God in you, because the Prophet of Islam says, Al-taqwa ahunna, that is, the fear of Allah is not shown in your face. It doesn't show in my face. It doesn't show in anybody's face. It's me. Meaning that you are supposed to be going with the fear of Allah anywhere you go.
Thank you very much. Abdul Kamil Imame, Islamic educationist. Thank you for sharing your
thoughts with us.